All right, we back. Welcome to 997. We got a special guest in the building.
Yeah, baby.
Money all the way from Detroit. What's good, my guy?
What's up, my guy?
Yeah, show you the good people the chain.
You got to show the J. You feel me? Got to unzip. Show the J out. Show the J out for sure.
Yeah, what's good, bro? Nice to have you, bro.
I appreciate it.
What you doing out here in New York, bro?
No, we got the show tonight. Me, Skilla, Tate B, Rafa. Now we got the show. I don't know the exact venue. It got switched around, but we got a crazy show tonight.
Nice. You've been eating good since you've been out here. What's the spots? Where they take you to since you?
Where
been
I been? I ate Shake Shack like four times already.
Nah, that's
y'all.
Crazy.
You gotta tell me the spots right to go to.
All right, after we got you.
Yeah, for sure.
But all right, man. Let's tell me a little bit about your background. We're gonna jump into it for people who may not know, bro. Where you from? 12th Street, the whole Detroit area. Let some people know, like, if they never heard your music, what's the vibe?
If you ain't never heard my music, it's all getting money, you feel me?
Yeah.
Keep the hood straight, keep your guys straight, keep your family straight. That's what it's about. The message is go get some money, you feel what I'm saying? Stay out the way, stay out of people's way, and just make your own surroundings. Like, you can do whatever you want to do for real. I'm from 12th Street, not the 12th Street off BMF, the 12th Street where Motown was created at.
Yeah.
Berry Gordy, manager in the middle, Derek Coleman was born at that played for the 76ers, so it was already stars in my area. Like, so
yeah,
it probably was meant.
Yeah, shout out to Derek Coleman. He used to play for the Nets. I'm from Jersey, so.
Oh, yeah. That's like my uncle. That's the reason I don't swim right now. I jumped in it. I never knew diving boards was for, like, deep feet. I went to his house, his mansion. I jumped off the diving board and jumped in the pool, and I didn't know it was 12 feet. I almost drowned, so to this day, I don't know how to swim.
That's crazy. So, damn, that's insane, actually. Talk about basketball or how you even got connected for the neighborhood.
He created a park in our hood to where, like, to keep the kids out of all the BS, you feel what I'm saying? He made a park, and it was a summer league every year. So every year, it was, like, instead of age groups, it went from, like, high school, college, NBA.
Okay.
So three different sessions.
Skill
so,
sets.
Yeah, so every year, you know, you'll be going to a different lead or a different team, and your team was named by the schools that was in the city.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? Then when you get to college, it's named by the colleges. And
okay.
It made people want to do it because niggas feel like that. This the NBA, it's the NBA of the hood.
Yeah.
If he can do it, like, he's sitting right here with us weekend, you feel me? So he's
the
inspiration to make us get up off our feet and, like, really want to do something.
And if I'm not mistaken, you are a hooper. You a hooper?
Yeah, for sure. All because of him and my guy, Dad, Terry Jones, he coached the whole hood.
Okay.
My whole neighborhood called him Coach.
Okay, what's the stat line looking like? What's the number one stat line?
I don't remember my stat lines right. But anybody that'll tell you that ever hooped with me in high school, middle school, I'm good, dub a game. No funny. Okay. I ain't making nothing up. And that's on the light end.
Okay. All right, bet. I give you that. Playground hero. Playground legend.
Playground legend.
Yeah.
From my way?
In your neighborhood.
Oh, my God.
What's the court you play on in your block? Like, what's the?
Oh, Derek Coleman court, Leon Bradley court.
Okay,
hey,
so you the playground legend over there.
No. It's real. Steppers over there.
Okay,
it's people who in the league now who came from there, who played over there. Or if they ain't in the league, they overseas. All you feel what I'm saying?
Nice.
You had to come through our way if you was really hooping, though, for sure.
Fire. So another thing I read, I think your block was the same block the riot started on.
Oh, yeah, 1967, right?
So, you can speak on that kind of, like, how was your family still there at the time?
Yeah,
like,
my family had a house on that block since that day.
Yeah.
My grandma was in a bar that it happened at, like, before the fire even started. She was in a bar when the police raided it. My aunties went to jail that night. The riot all happened because everybody went to jail that night, and the police raided the little bar that it was at.
And you feel like, obviously, all of that combined with the hoops,
it's kind of informed something
your music.
Was meant.
Yeah.
Something was meant for me to do as I was in the right area.
Right, and this is 8 mile, 7 mile. Where we at?
It's 12th Street.
It's 12th Street. The
riot started on 12th Street,
too.
Claremont, Rosa Park.
All right. Nah, that's fire, bro.
Atkinson to be exact, the block behind Claremont.
Yeah. All right, so from there, man, like, what other influences did you have growing up, like, in terms of, like, music? I read your pops was in a rap group.
I didn't even know that growing up. I knew that when I turned like 15.
Yeah, you were 15 years old, you found out.
I found out that he was rapping and all that. Like, I always knew he was in the movie 8 Mile, like, when Eminem was battling, he was in the background and stuff. Like, but I never knew he rapped. I just heard his music myself, like, his voice.
Yeah.
Myself, like, probably 2 years ago.
That's crazy. And you say, does his music, sound anything like what's going on in Detroit right now? Or
it
like
sounded exactly how it's going on in Detroit. Right
same
now.
Thing.
And not like, no, not the same thing. Let's not say, because they was in a whole another era of, you feel what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like this era is weed. That era was that street, the other shit. You feel yeah. me? So, and you hear that's what he talk about in the music. So yeah. It's like, damn, I finally get to see what he was going through or what he was feeling like at least.
Yeah, that's amazing, bro. So do you feel like subconsciously that's why you started doing music, or was it other influences?
Oh, no, your siblings, I was doing music things? Before I knew he rapped.
Okay, so he was already on that.
Yeah, I was doing music on the fun of it. Like my cousin, Lotto Boy Shiny, taught me how to rap.
Yeah.
And my other cousin, Lotto Boy Say, taught me how to put four bars together and switch it up.
Right.
And it was fun. That's why they was teaching me to do it for yeah. to be able to be on the song.
Yeah.
Then my voice sounded sweet. I was saying sweet shit. So now it's like, all right, let's do it every day. And it'd be fun. I'm not even shooting videos to it. Like I got okay. music. It was music by myself, but I never dropped a solo.
Okay.
Like Aunt Beast just signed to Rock Nation here.
Oh, that's
from
fire.
My city. I made my first solo in his closet.
Right. I think the first time, I think your other cousin, you ain't mentioned 1800.
Well, oh, yeah. That's just like one of my closest friends. He took me to my first studio.
Okay.
I didn't even know my high school had a studio, but they was letting him come out of class to go make beats.
Oh,
and he
right.
let me go in there.
Nah, he put me on the, that was the first time I heard like V's and Baby Ray.
Yeah, yeah. Oh, yeah.
I didn't know.
Yeah, he legendary in our way.
Okay. That's fire. So, all right. So, speak on how you transitioned kind of from your old how you started, which was like Baby Lowe's, they used to call you
Money Team Baby.
Yeah. And then
that was my first rap name. Money okay. Team Baby. Baby Lowe's is like what my whole hood called me.
Okay. And then transitioning to Baby Money.
Yeah, because my brother,
what's the name,
my
what's the
brother
story?
Is Tello's Money.
Okay.
You feel what I'm saying? I was already Baby, you feel me? It was just
yeah.
the money. And I always liked the money since I was a kid. They used to call me Dollar in my hood because I asked everybody for dollars.
Yeah.
So money came about and it just stuck.
And okay, so now Baby Money, like the fusion of both. You
yeah,
being
yeah,
the Baby Lowe's and you asking
yeah,
for a dollar. It's like that's Baby
exactly,
Money right there.
Exactly.
That's fire. So right now, what you've been working on, like in terms of how the tour is going, how you've been transitioning from being in Detroit to traveling around, dealing, being with a new dad, all of that. Like
I'm moving the same in every state. You hear me?
Yeah.
You told me, wait, in any city or state.
Yeah, step.
My hustle never stopped like a car with bad brakes. You hear me?
Yeah.
So, but I like it though. Like, so this is my first actual tour. Like,
mm-hmm.
you get what I'm saying? And like actually being on the road, them hours you get, all you see is grass. That shit, how you thinking? Like, all right, I'm doing this shit for a reason or something. Something got to come out of this. You feel me? So. That's the part. But the dad part is like the best part. Dad, I be missing the shit out of my son.
Yeah. You say that's probably the hardest part.
We just
part.
On FaceTime when he walked in. That's,
yeah.
Yeah. I be wanting to go back home and just, you feel me?
Anytime you can.
Anytime, even if it's for a day or two, just jump right back on the road.
Nah, I feel you, bro. Ain't nothing like being the dad. This shit probably the hardest
shit
thing
to
do.
Soft.
Yeah.
Shit make you soft, you feel me?
Yeah, that's what everybody say. It's a good thing, though. And you're right. You got something to work for now, so it ain't even like, you need outside motivation. He already got it built in for you, bro. Mm-hmm. Nah, that's fire. So what's the biggest learning lesson from tour so far?
Don't fuck with North Carolina Riley.
Oh, my God. Speak on it, because I ain't going to lie, bro. I lived in North Carolina. That's crazy. So
man, Riley,
so what happened?
I smoked Black of Miles the whole day there. They took a nigga to jail. Somebody threw a blunt out at the car. They took him to jail, him and his girl. I said, yeah, we won't be smoking no time here. I had to go to Charlotte. We waited a whole day to smoke.
That's crazy, bro. That's crazy. I ain't gonna lie. The first time I got in trouble for smoking butt was in North Carolina high school. Same shit. They are strict
it's
on that.
It's Commonwealth, and you know I'm one of those type of guys. Like I get to a state before I walk out to go smoke this butt, I'm about to look at the laws on Google.
Yeah.
Is weed legal here?
Nah,
man, we looked it up. That shit say weed is a federal crime to possess or have. I say yeah, we ain't gonna be smoking out here.
Yeah, bro. We don't want you on your ASAP Rocky, you know.
Hell no. Nah. Yeah, he went to jail out there?
He went to jail in like Copenhagen or where Sweden or some shit. Sweden overseas because he had some other shit going on.
Oh, yeah.
But we can't get you locked up for no drugs, basically.
Nah, hell no.
Over smoking. That shit's stupid. But it's legal out here. You ain't been to no dispensaries or nothing?
No, I'll be out here.
All right,
you
so.
You feel me? My people be out here. They gonna
you said you don't need it. All right, yeah. But all right, bro. I mean, other than that, what you got coming up? Like, you got new. I know you just dropped some shit. You've been dropping the video.
If Wayne don't tell me I could drop tomorrow, I'll drop tomorrow.
Oh, you got shit locked up like that.
I drop the next day.
Okay.
And the next day. And the next day.
All right.
It's like that.
So what's the
challenge me, please?
What's the recording schedule like? How do you like to record?
Man,
you a punch in every night? What you writing?
I've been punching in for 7 years.
Okay. So
last time I wrote, I was in jail.
Okay, downtime.
That'll make you write some crazy shit, won't it?
That'll help you. Not even speaking on that, bro, because you could kind of transition from when you dropped the Montclair bubble before you signed the deal.
Yeah,
that
for
was
sure.
Like coming right out the pandemic, though. You
I ain't write
down.
That.
Oh, well, yeah. When I ain't write that. When you dropped that.
Yeah, I ain't write that. That was all out the head. I didn't even think that was going to be the song.
Yeah, so can you speak on how, like, the pandemic might have, what was the playbook you built out in the pandemic? Because
the pandemic was
pre-pandemic, you was in this spot. And then you came out 2021, the song, you got signed. Yeah, speak on that. What you learned during that little period of time?
Man, do whatever the fuck you want to do.
Yeah.
You only live once. Do whatever you want to do.
Make it work.
Make that shit happen. Fuck work. Make it happen. You hear me?
Nah, for real. All right. So I found one of your first songs you uploaded on your YouTube. You know what shit it is?
Is it with Ashanti?
The shit with Ashanti on it.
Ashanti.
Why you leave that one song up from 8 years? Or was it 8 years ago? Or 10 years ago?
So the baby just did that over with Ashanti. He took my idea, didn't he?
Yeah, he did.
I did that years ago, the baby. You feel me? Yeah. That's my God, though. I still mess
you got
with
the
it.
Receipts. It's still up. It's still up.
You feel me? But I was already thinking how I think now. Like, hey, my name, baby, this would be a perfect. I wish I knew Ashanti then. You feel what I'm saying? It probably would have been a little better, but that's why. Like.
And then what had you even getting into the?
My city, like, the world don't know that song, right? But my city know the song. Like, so my city does still listen to that song.
Yeah, that's like probably one of her biggest songs, like, you know what I'm saying? But what made you even do that back then? Like, was it like older siblings? Like, what was that?
No, that was just all my thoughts.
That was all your thought process.
My mind always been like this.
Yeah.
I swear to God.
Yeah, and that's even why they recently, you were saying, what, QC was more interested in some other songs. Like, they first got you signed.
Chrome Heart.
And Chrome Heart had the same type of, it was a sample in it. So you've been on that vibe. So before, is even like a trendy shit.
My manager brought that song up, and while we was in the studio with Helluva, they made the beat in my face, and we just did it.
Yeah, and that's the one. Nah, yeah, that's. I feel like that's probably one of your. That's your style almost. Like that's when you in your most craziest bag when you catch a sample, and you talking your bag shit.
Somebody asked me right now, like, what type of beat? I'm gonna ask you first. Like, you got a sample in there? Like, play that first.
Okay. So have you locked in with your own like producer that got you that sound now, or are you still searching for that?
Like, 1-800 is the only producer I'm gonna pick whatever beat, like, you feel me? But other than that, I be trying to work with anybody. If your beat sweet, you feel me? You don't gotta be a big person. You could be coming up. The people coming up be better than everybody right now because they put their heart into it. They be trying to get rich. You feel what I'm saying? So it be like that.
All right, so tell me who's coming up? Who in Detroit? Who we looking out for? That's who got in that bag.
You got Ty Beast, you got EJ Beast, man, EJ beefing. You gonna see this right now. You got EJ Beast, Ty Beast. Who else make beats?
Or even just even rappers. Like, who in the city should we be looking out for in general?
On the beat wise?
And rapping. Rapping,
oh,
beats.
Rapping?
Yeah.
You got 1UP T, you got 3G Weezy, you got J-Bo.
Yeah.
You got Lotto Boy Shiny. You got Stereo Gotti, you got Babyface E. The whole Detroit is really rapping right now. I'm talking about, and it's not though, like not back in the day. You see somebody rapping, everybody else start rapping too.
Yeah,
everybody's talking crazy. So
I feel like a lot of y'all Detroit rappers who have come out, y'all been rapping for a long time. Like it's not like y'all new, and it was just y'all moment. And now
new
the people
to the industry.
Yeah, new to the industry. Exactly.
New to the industry. For
that's
sure.
Kind of like the Detroit way, I guess. We might be rapping for a while. Get your money up, and then people start paying attention.
Yeah, we know to live off that distro kid. Like, you feel me? Like, we don't know if we're going to get signed or not, so let's drop music every day.
Yeah.
You feel what I'm saying? I bet that give me some money.
Yeah, nah, for sure. So, all right, speak on that. Independent versus being on, you've been on the label a little minute now. What's the benefits? What you think?
Label is better. They got a bigger platform. They know better people. You feel what I'm saying? It's rooms that we probably never get in if we don't know some of these people. You feel what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So it's like a friendship thing and making them family. You feel what I'm saying? So label for sure.
Label for sure. I mean, if you want those Cartier buffs, the Cartier buffs, do you want them sent straight to the crib? You got to be on the label.
Unless you got like a billion, you're going to need some cheese.
Yeah.
You're going to need some cheese.
Yeah, nah, I feel you. Yeah, bro, I mean, that's really it. I just want, you want any announcements, anything you want to?
Take care of y'all kids.
Yeah.
You feel what I'm saying? It's Father's Day in a couple of days. Take care of y'all kids. Make sure they healthy and safe.
Yeah.
My son is a pit bull mixed with a canine. Anybody playing with us, you feel me?
But yeah, open them savings accounts, man. Stop playing.
What I'm saying?
Yeah, all right.
Make sure they straight.
Yeah, make sure they straight. That's it, bro. Thank you, bro.
I appreciate you.
And then, other than that, bro, we got to do the drop for it. You
Hey, this Baby Money, I'm performing Shining on Not 97, yeah. Andrew was loud. I had to walk him down on 2 feet. Day 14, she bought that pussy 2 weeks. Bust a brick out the wrapper like a loose leaf. They dropping sugar, not salt. This road too sweet. Old plug, we just trapping on a new street. We really worth some millions, nigga, so we move deep. Pressing A bag, we get this a 2-3. This ain't that old Louis drip, this a new season. You know I came to break the bank, it's a burglary. Fly to Columbia, you about to get some surgery. Pull up in the 9-11, emergency. Nah, he ain't married, he just bought the anniversary. Of me and Cash and my fam, I was the first to see. Nah, he ain't cool, he just trying to get a verse for free. Orange bullets in the chop, got a nerf with me. I'm with the grave diggers, tell the pastor, bring the hearse to me.